Hey everybody, what's going on? It's your man, Corey. Welcome to the Digital Dash, where I be giving you guys tips on how to market your songs and get those numbers booming. Now, if you're new to the channel, I am a digital marketer. I specialize in helping artists like yourself get their songs heard through platforms like Spotify, like Instagram, like YouTube, and a bunch of others. Now, what I want to talk with you guys about today is a way that you can spy on your competition's Facebook ads so that you can use them for some inspiration for your own. Now, this tool that I'm going to show you is Certified Facebook Legit. There's nothing crazy going on there. It's a tool that I personally use to, like I said, get inspiration for my Facebook ads, for my clients, and the things that I have going on. And it's something that ever since it's been brought to my attention, I figured that it's something that you guys would benefit to know about. But before we get into all of that, come follow me on Instagram. I make sure to leave my at name on the screen. Come talk to me, come engage with me, come give me some video ideas, all of that good stuff. Now, with that being said, let's get right into it. Now, what I've realized about running Facebook ads since I've been doing it is that once you really know what you're doing, the targeting isn't the hard part, right? Like, for those of you who have practiced or set up your own Facebook ads, you know that setting up the ad, figuring out where to target, figuring out where to run it, figuring out your daily budget, that's not the hard part, right? The hard part is coming up with the creative and the copy. And for those of you who don't know, the creative is pretty much the content that you're using for the ad. The copy is pretty much the words that you put in the description box. What text is going to actually be underneath the video or the picture that you're using. So this tool that I found out that allows you guys to spy on other artists' Facebook ads, whether it be major label artists or smaller independent artists who have just figured it out, is something that I've been using personally to kind of step up my ad game, to get some ideas and to get some inspiration. And this tool that I'm talking about is the Facebook Ad Archive. Now, just a really quick quiz. Could you guys guess why Facebook has created an ad archive? I'll give you guys a second to think about it. Facebook pretty much created this ad archive to increase their transparency and to pretty much increase their trust with us, the consumers, after everything that happened with the elections and Russia and Donald Trump and all of that. Pretty much Facebook is backtracking and saying, oh, you guys can't blame us for ads because now you can see every ad that's being ran. And because of that, you guys now get the opportunity to spy on people who are running Facebook ads at a high level. So you're able to see what types of content major label artists are using for their ads, how many ads are they running, the copy that they're using, which, like I said, personally, that's the hardest part for me. Now, the only thing it doesn't show you is how they're running their targeting system. Who are they running it to? And just to show you guys a little bit more information, I want to take you into the back end of the Facebook ad archive so that you can see how it works. And I'll let you all know pretty much how I personally get inspiration from it and how I use it. All right, guys, so here we are inside of the Facebook ad library. Now, all you need to do to get here is very simple. Facebook.com/ads/library, and it'll bring you to the exact screen that I'm on. So as you can see, it even says here, the ad library provides advertising transparency by offering a comprehensive searchable collection of all ads, blah, 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 blah. What they're basically saying is, here's everybody's ads so you can see them and you won't blame us for anything because we're being transparent with you about what's going on the platform. So all you need to do to pretty much get your research started is just make a list of artists that from time to time you want to check in on to see if they're running ads, how they're running ads, and how you can get some inspiration from them. So let me think of somebody who just came out with a project. I know YG just came out with something, so let's do YG. So I would just search YG. Once his profile pops up, click on it, boom, brings me to this screen. So outside of just the general ad information that we'll get to in a second, if you come over to the page transparency side and click see more, it just shows you a bunch of information about this page. So YG created his page on March 10th, 2010. He's never changed the page name, never merged with another page. He has 65 plus people managing this account. Dang, he must have a lot of people managing his ad account. So it pretty much just gives you some history on different Facebook pages, pretty much so you can see if it's someone who's been like bouncing around trying to scam you or something like that. It doesn't really apply too much to the music side. But like in business and dealing with businesses, it helps to see if like this person has changed their name 6 times, they must have done something really sketchy in the past or something like that. Or you can see some people going through like brand changes and things. Now, the fun part, what we want to see is his ads, right? So as you can see, YG is currently running 62 separate ads. So if you see where it says results, how it says 62 results right underneath the profile picture, that is how many ads are currently running from this account. YG is running 62 different ads. My guess is different ads to target different locations or different ads to target different audience sets that he's created. That's the best guess that I can make. So if you scroll through here, these are pretty much all of the ads that YG is running. So We'll start back at the top. So he has an ad that's, I'm going to guess, for his merch, because that looks like a cassette tape. He has another merch ad. This long one right here is, I'm going to guess, a story ad. He has another ad. Oh, let's click out of that. He has another ad for his show in New York with Schoolboy Q. So YG's running pretty much a good amount of ads. Oh, and he has another video ad linking directly to the album. So YG's running a pretty good amount of ads. So we see he's running ads to target people to his shows, ads to target people to his merch, and ads to target people to his project. And I'll show you how you can tell. I'll show you how you can tell in a little bit. So let's click on this merch ad right here, right? So if you want to see more details on the ad, all you would need to do is click see ad details. Now, it doesn't really get too specific. Like, it's not going to tell you what type of ad YG is running. It pretty much just shows you how the ad looks while it's in motion. So let's check it out. So yeah, pretty simple motion graphic ad he's running here for the merch. I'm guessing the merch. We're going to see in a second. So yeah, he has the hot sauce bottle, the cassette tape. Very simple ad. Go Local at the top. Special price, $12 out now. And like I said, this is what I would mostly use this platform for. This is what I personally use this platform for, is for ad copy inspiration and ad inspiration in general for the creative. So you can see YG kept it pretty simple with this ad. For real, the album out now. He let the picture pretty much do the talking. Here's the hot sauce. Here's the cassette tape. And actually, let's check that out. It says shop now, so I'm pretty sure it's going to link out to the merch store. And yep, I was right. So clicking that ad or swiping up on the ad, however it comes up on your feed, will pretty much link you out directly to his hot sauce. He probably has the pixel on here. I'm going to assume that I'm going to start getting retargeted in a little bit, or not even a little bit, but pretty soon from this ad, just from doing this. So yeah, so let's go check out another ad. Let's check out the one for the show. So here's his ad for his show. Once again, the copy is pretty simple. Come and see me and Schoolboy Q live in concert tomorrow, May 30th at ESPN House in NYC. Free show during the game, blah, 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 blah. Use code YG House below to get yours. So this is what I mostly use this platform for. Outside of like my music artist clients, I use it mostly for Blue Summer, which Blue Summer is a festival event that me and my friends do here in Atlanta. So what I'll do is I'll go look at Rolling Loud's ads. I'll go look at Broccoli Fest ads. I was checking out something in the Waters Fest ad right before that came up. And I'll see how they're doing their copy for their artists. And then we'll take it and change it around for the ads that we're running. So that's pretty much what I use it for. And the way that you can tell what type of ads he's running, like I said, you can't tell if he's doing a traffic ad. You pretty much can't tell what the campaign objective is, but you can guesstimate as to what type of ad this is. So like these shorter square ones are more than likely feed ads. And these longer ones are more than likely story ads, like for either Facebook story or Instagram story, just based off of the way they look. And this ad right here, let's see what it is. Okay, so it's a clip from his video linking out to, I'm going to guess, his album, because it looks like he has a smart link here, yg.link.to. Let's see. So yeah, so pretty much he links it out to a smart link that links you to all the platforms that his music is on. So those are the types of ads that YG is running. So let's look at another artist just to kind of see, just to get a little bit more something into it. There's another artist, Ari Lennox. I know Ari Lennox just dropped the project. I'm sure she's doing something. Ari Lennox is Dreamville's, one of the Dreamville's newest act. And she is. So she's currently running 35 different ads. So she has an ad right here that is linking out to her music video. Yep, a clip from the music scene, a clip from the music video linking out to the entire video, because she has a smart URL as well. She's tracking the traffic that's coming in. And that's another thing you can do, is you can pretty much see how our major label acts, how are acts that have entire teams of marketers, people who are being hired to copyright, people who are being hired to create the creatives, like the actual ad, people who are being hired to set this stuff up and track it. What are they using to do it? You know, what type of smart links are they using? What do they feel like is a good ad? This is pretty much what you can use the ad library for. And this is pretty much what I use it for. It's a great source of inspiration, especially for those of you who are just starting to get into running ads and who do run into the problem of, what can I use to create an ad? What will I write for the ad? How many do I need? Use this as your inspiration. So yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. I just wanted to show you all this Facebook ad library. Check it out. Let me know what you think.
Let's get back to the rest of the video.
So there it is, guys. That's pretty much the Facebook ad archive. Now go ahead, use it to get inspiration for your own Facebook ads. Use it to make your game a little bit better, and use it for when you're in a place and you're stuck and you pretty much don't know what type of content to use for the ad. I would recommend just making like a side list of artists that are in your demo, and from time to time checking on them and see what types of ads they're running. So like I said, you can use it as a base for your inspiration. Now, I know that after the Google Ads video, a lot of you guys hit me and were asking pretty much to make a similar video on how to run Facebook ads. And the reason that I haven't done so is because as of honestly about 2 weeks ago, actually probably a month before making this video, I have dropped a course on my website that is specifically dedicated towards teaching you guys how to run Facebook ads and Google ads and use influencers and niche Instagram pages to market a video. So that's pretty much the reason I haven't put out a Facebook ad video is you're gonna have to go pay for that info, bro. But I'll make sure to leave a link to that in the description below. Go ahead, check it out. Let me know what you think. If you've paid for it, let me know if you've learned anything. And outside of that, let me know how you guys find the Facebook ad archive. Comment below if you've used it before. Let me know who you found out that's running ads that kind of surprised you. All of that good stuff right there. Now, as always, guys, if you feel like you learned anything today, please like and share this video. Hit those post notifications as well, as I wouldn't want you guys to miss anything. Once again, my name is Corey, and I'll see y'all next time.